we look at one area where business is booming in Israel. We're staying in Israel for the next few moments. Our focus, Israeli company Caesarstone. Up to four private equity firms are battling to buy the kitchen worktop maker, which is majority owned by a kibbutz. Once a byword for collective farming, they have proved surprisingly fertile ground for creating new industries. Elliot Gotkin reports.
If you own a quartz kitchen worktop, chances are it comes from here. Caesarstone exports to more than 40 countries. Sales last year hit almost $400 million. Not bad for a company started from scratch by Socialist Farming Co-op, or Kibbutz.
It runs like every other company. And the part that there is a community here, yes, it matters, but not to the core values or to the core decision that are taken in order to take the company forward.
This kibbutz is still involved in agriculture. There are avocados and bananas being grown over there, and just over here, you've got dairy cows, but the overwhelming majority of revenues now for this community come from manufacturing.
It's not the only one. Industries on kibbutzim generated almost $9 billion last year. That's almost 10% of Israel's industrial production, 4% of GDP, and some five times the amount they made from farming. This industrial revolution of Israel's kibbutzim wasn't an accident. Locked in a death spiral of mechanization and falling profits, they bet the farm on industry in the 1960s. But the billions they borrowed to do that almost broke them, along with Israel's banks. To save the kibbutz from oblivion, this man was tapped to help restructure their debts. So spectacular were the results, he now invests in kibbutz companies like Caesarstone, which came back from the brink.
From being totally bankrupted, with over hundreds of millions of shekel in direct debts, the members of the kibbutz are now, each one of them, is now a millionaire. In dollar terms, it's unbelievable.
Even kibbutzim that have stuck to their roots have had to branch out. Gan Shmuel, north of Tel Aviv, moved into food processing and owns a retail park. But its members still eat together and pool their wages in a central pot, which is then dispensed equally by family size.
People came to the kibbutz in the beginning because we had to build Israel. And that's the reason why it was mostly agriculture. Today, in 2012, I think people live on the kibbutz because it's comfortable. The part of ideology has become smaller. But I think it's in the base of our living. I mean, we really believe in being together. It's better than being alone.
And if kibbutz members and Israel get a little richer along the way, well, they can probably live with that. Elliot Gotkin, Bloomberg, Caesarea, Israel.